بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين حمدا كثيرا دائما طيبا مباركا فيه وحمدا كما ينبغي لجلال وجهه وعظيم سلطانه الحمد لله الذي عاد علينا روحنا وعافانا في جسدنا وآذن لنا بذكره وبعد صلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما. Today we will speak about Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم and the love of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. It is not a choice of us as Muslims to love the Prophet or not. No. It is out of our choice. It is kind of an order. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "La yu'min ahadukum hatta akunu ahabb ilayhi min nafsi wa ahlihi wan nas ajma'in." None of you will be a true believer. There is a Muslim and there is a true believer, which is higher than the degree of just a Muslim. So he said, none of you will be a true believer, a real, real good Muslim, unless he loves me more than himself, loved the Prophet ﷺ more than himself. And love me more than his family. And love me more than the whole Lord. Only then, when you feel you have that, you are from those who are true believers. Because there's so many degrees. Among the main three degrees, Islam, Iman, Ihsan. And each one of the three main degrees in Islam, stages, Islam, and then Iman, and then Ihsan. The main, each one of them has 67 different degrees. Each one of the three main stages, Islam, Iman, Ihsan, first stage, minimum is just a Muslim in Islam. Higher one is Iman, when his Islam, his belief, his practice, everything becomes stronger. Then he is among believers, among Mu'mins. And then when he is high, like Awliya, like people who have a good relation with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it becomes in the stages of Ihsan. Each one of the three stages has 67 different degrees. So when we say that none of you will be, or when the Prophet ﷺ said, none of you will be a true believer until. So the true believer is maybe is not Islam, not a minimum, just a Muslim. No. In the second stage, which is Iman, that in that stage, and high one as well, high in it, those who love the Prophet ﷺ more than anybody, more than anything, because his favors upon us is huge. Not only 1400 years ago when he was, no, until today. He says your action is demonstrated in the front of me every day. And the good one of it makes me happy. And the bad action it showed to me that a Muslim did, it upsets me. So one of the companions said to him, Rasulullah, isn't it that you die, you become dust? No? He said, no. He said, earth forbidden by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to use, to take, or to eat, or to use prophets' bodies. So he is there, his body there, and his soul there, maybe not inside, but he's there. And he said, until the day of judgment, anything you do good, it will be demonstrated to me, in the front of me, a sheet, a noise. And if it is good, I'll be happy. If it is not, I'll be upset and I'll make dua for you. So until today, and always, he is checking our action. Allah gave him this quality. He is not a simple da'iyah. When in Isra al-Mi'raj, when the Prophet ﷺ and Jibreel went through the seven heavens, every time Jibreel knocked on the door of each heaven, says, the guardian of this door asked, who is it? Said to him, Jibreel. And then he says to him, who is with you? Because Jibreel used to just fly, die. He has his own way. But in the night of Isra al-Mi'raj, he had to go through there because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to the guardians of these doors that one day Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will pass by you. You would see him. And they were so happy and waited. He is not just a da'i. He is so close to Allah. And he, Allah says in the Quran, وَعَلَّمُوا أَنَّ فِيكُمْ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ. Learn that the Prophet is among you. He didn't say when or before or later. I just left the verse like that. وَعَلَّمُوا أَنَّ فِيكُمْ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ. Because there is some groups, one set in Islam now, deal with the Prophet ﷺ as a da'iyah. And these people, their ancestors, soon after the Rasulullah ﷺ, they tried to kill his family. They're jealous. And jealous produces hatred from about 10-15 years after the Prophet died, they start taking action. And some of them, these groups are there, are here, around here now. So they consider him just a man. Just a man. While Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, I know that he's among you. And he said, no. Allah said, he's أَعْلَمُ أَنَّ فِيكُمْ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ. A prophet is among you. He was, and he's still, and he's always going to be. He's in charge of us. Allah wanted this way. Because when our action demonstrated to him, show it to him every day, for all Muslims. If it was bad, he made istighfar for us. He made dua for us, so we benefit still today and always. وَعْلَمُوا أَنَّ فِيكُمْ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ. When Allah brings a verse like this in the Quran, that the Prophet ﷺ is among you, So it has a message to us. And the message means when I say Sallu ala Nabi, make salah, salawat on Nabi, Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, you do. That message that the Prophet is among you, me be alert and listen to what he says. He says, none of you will be a true believer until he loves me more than his family, more than his people, more than his children, more than. That's how it should be if you want to be a true believer. But let's come back to the word love. Love has signs. Hatred has signs. Anger has signs. Everything has signs. It shows on the person if he is happy, if he is love, if he is hatred, hate, and so on. So everything has signs. If you want to know if you love the Prophet or not, you check the signs. Signs, when someone mentions his name, you say Salah al-Nabi. Straight. Signs that you wanted to give him a gift. What is the gift you can give? For example, you come one day when you walk in and wait in a bus stop or whatever, you make 50 Salah al-Nabi gift to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Check the signs. Among the signs that you live, be grateful to his good action toward us, brought Islam to us. Check our action every day. He has a lot of favors among us. So we have to say Salah. What is Salah ala Nabi? Salah ala Nabi means, Allah, I wish that you give Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam a lot of mercy, a lot of salam from us, a lot of goodness to Rasulullah. Every time we say, Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammadin wa alihi wa sallam, you are actually asking Allah, take all these wishes and gifts from us, Rasulullah. Give him mercy, give him our best wishes, give him, be happy about him. This is the meaning of Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammadin wa sallam. The meaning of sending salawat to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Because when you sent it, you are starting by the word Allah. Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad. Not like these groups again, which is some of them, when he stand to give khutbah or some other action, he say, I make salah ala Nabi. No. The one who makes salah ala Nabi is Allah. And we just mentioned that. Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad wa alihi wa sallam. So, one of the gifts is to make salah ala Nabi and send it to him. Which means, oh Allah, give him mercy, give him love, give him. Every time you say, alayhi salatu wassalam, Allahumma salli ala sallam, you ask him, Allah, give Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam all these things. And salah ala Nabi has a very, very important item. And that is, when you say salah ala Nabi, once, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent 10 salah to you. He said that, he said in hadith, من صلى علي مرة صلى الله عليه عشر. Whoever makes salah al salawat for me, he will get 10 from Allah. There is no other action in Islam. Entitle a Muslim to have Allah make salah on him 10 times except salah on Nabi. That's how important the relation with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That when you make salah on him, you benefit so much. Let's come back to the science of love of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This science is a science of being a true believer. It is a science which it shows that you have a proof in your belief, in your state of Islam. Among the signs, you always, when you see people, you like to talk nice about Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Among the signs that you always wanted to say Salah Nabi whenever you hear his name. Among the signs that you show to someone who doesn't talk nice about Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, teaching, that's no good. He is our Rasulullah. Among the signs that you celebrate his birth, because one of the non-Muslims in the time of before the beginning of Islam, when the Prophet was about to be born to become human, he had an uncle, and the uncle sent one of his slaves and said to her, go and check to see Sayyida Amina has delivered what? Because they were not happy if it was a girl. Because he wanted to know if his nephew is a good baby, meaning a boy, or not. So she came back, and at the end of the day she said, Sayyida Amina brought a boy. So he was so happy that his nephew is a boy, not a girl. And he freed her. Said, go, you are free. And go and tell so-and-so to take 20 camel, kill them, distribute them in everybody. Abdullah got a son. He actually celebrated the birth of Rasulullah. He is the first one to do it, ever. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decided to reduce his punishment because he died as non-Muslim. Allah decided to reduce his punishment. So there is a reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for those who celebrate the Prophet's birthday. And celebrating the Prophet's birthday is among the signs of love of Rasulullah. And this sign and this love of Rasulullah, sign of being a true believer. So we have to watch the signs that we love the Prophet. Because this sign, as we said, is a sign of being me. As I want to say, Salah Nabi, this is the sign which shows that I have a true belief.
this time I'm listening to the Rasulullah's advice that none of you will be a true believer unless he loved me more than himself. And he had people in his time, Uncle Sam at that time, he used to love Rasulullah so much that he wouldn't go home. He finished the service and attendance. He won't sit at the near place until he come and see him again. See the Prophet again. So, the silence is very important that you watch it and you know it. And you work on it and improve it in yourself. And among it, of course, our most, one of the most important is that you, whenever you hear his name, you make salah, Ali. And you increase the amount of salah every day than the day before. You always have to, the effort to do some effort to benefit from the salah, increase it every day a few more than the day before. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our ibadah and our salah and the deen.